Hi, in this video we are going to see gate previous year questions with answers for electrical engineering, electrical machines, set number 4. In this set we are going to see 10 different questions. Group 1 lists the different application, group 2 lists the motors for these applications, match the application with the most suitable motor and choose the right combination among the choices given thereafter. Okay, group 1, food mixer, cassette tape recorder, domestic water pump, escalators. Group 2, permanent magnet DC motor, single phase induction motor, universal motor, 3 phase motor, DC series motor, stepper motor. Okay. Universal motor. Generally, universal motors are used in almost all the places. They are used in vacuum cleaners, domestic swing pump, mixers, portable drilling machine. Okay. For small toys and cassette tape recorder, permanent magnet DC motors are used. Okay, and low capacity domestic application, single phase induction motor is mostly used. 3 phase induction motors are used in escalators. It is almost used in most of the industries. More than 80% of the industrial motors are 3 phase induction motors. Okay, so food mixer, universal motor is the right choice. Okay, cassette tape recorder, permanent magnet DC motor is the right choice. Domestic water pump, it is a low capacity pump, it is a single phase induction motor. Escalators, 3 phase induction motors has been used. Okay, so choice C is the right answer. Okay, no load test on a 3 phase induction motor was conducted different supply frequency. Okay, and a plot of input power versus voltage was drawn. The curve was extrapolated to intersect y axis. The intersection point yields, okay, here we will see the curve. So initially, as already mentioned, no load test we are doing. Okay, this particular no load test has been done for the induction motor. It is done for giving, it is done by using giving different supply voltages. Okay, and the waveform is drawn between the supply voltage and the input power. Here we can see in x axis the voltage and y axis we can see the input power. So V1 is the rated voltage we are giving initially. Okay, when we keep on reducing the voltage to V2, the input power drawn is keep on reducing. Okay, we can see here from the V1 to V2, the input power, that green line you can see, it is dropping. Okay, and they have mentioned this, they have mentioned that they are extrapolating this to intersect y axis. Okay, so now you can see the orange line. Okay, it has been interpolated and to touch the y-axis. Okay, so you can see the point A. V1 is the rated voltage, V2 is the voltage we are keep on reducing. Below V2 we are extrapolating in orange line. Okay, and it is connected to the input power line. So this is a point where voltage is 0, V equal to 0. Okay, at V equal to 0 normally there will not be any power. Okay, but it is extrapolated only for learning purpose. Okay, so we can see here from the supply voltage V1 to V2, the frictional losses remains constant. Okay, and V2, below V2, the developed torque is too small. Okay, and there will be a speed drop in the motor. Okay, and you can see here at the point of A, only mechanical losses has been there. Mechanical losses we can see constantly there. And when it is at V1 point, the mechanical losses and iron losses also there. When we keep on reducing, the iron loss component is reducing, and at the point A, there will not be any iron loss component. Okay, only mechanical loss component is there. So we can say here, if the intersection point yields friction and windage losses, it is only a mechanical losses. Okay, again I am repeating, the supply voltage is reduced from V1 to V2. Okay, so at V1 is the rated voltage, at the rated voltage input power drawn will be some value, and it is reducing to V2, and we can see the green line here. Below V2 we are extrapolating and intersecting at the y-axis. Okay, you can see the point A, and this is a point is voltage is 0. Okay, in when voltage is 0 there will not be any power. Okay, this is we are only for observation purpose we are seeing. Okay, at the point V1 the losses is mechanical losses plus iron losses at the rated voltage. At the point A, we can see here only mechanical losses. Okay, So the right answer is friction and windage losses, so mechanical losses. The direction of rotation of a three-phase induction motor is clockwise. When it is supplied with a three-phase sinusoidal voltage having a phase sequence ABC. For a counterclockwise rotation of the motor, the phase sequence of the power supply should be. Okay. Now the phase sequence of supply is ABC. Okay. It is rotating at clockwise. If you want to have counterclockwise, you have to change only two terminals. Okay. We can change the terminals B and C or A and B to get the counterclockwise direction. Okay. So the right combination will be A, C, B. Choice C is the right answer. Again, I'm repeating. The direction of rotation of a three-phase induction motor is clockwise when it is supplied with a three-phase sinusoidal voltage having a phase sequence of ABC. For a counterclockwise rotation of the motor, the phase sequence of the power supply, okay, for getting the counterclockwise direction, we have to change only one terminal. Here you can see in the choice A, they have changed it twice. If you do two times the change, it will be same as earlier. Okay. In here also, we can see it has been changed two times. So combination A, B, D and all will not be suitable. Here we can see A will be maintained and only B and C phase has been changed. So choice C is the right answer. Unbalanced supply voltage given to a three-phase delta connected induction motor will cause. Okay. Generally, unbalanced voltage can be written as a sum of positive sequence, negative sequence and zero sequence. Sorry, unsymmetrical voltage can be written as a symmetrical waveform to get positive sequence, negative sequence and zero sequence. Okay. Unbalanced supply voltage will be normally having a negative sequence component. Okay. Earth fault value will be always having a zero sequence component. Okay. Zero sequence current. So choice C is the right answer. Unbalanced supply voltage given to a three-phase delta connected induction motor will cause a negative sequence component current. A three-phase, four-pole squirrel cage induction motor has 36 stator and 28 rotor slots. The number of phases of the rotor. Okay. For a squirrel cage induction motor, the number of phases in the stator and rotor will be same. Okay. So here the answer is 3. A three-phase, four-pole squirrel cage induction motor has 36 stator and 28 rotor slots. The number of phases of the rotor is equal to 3. Because number of phases in stator and rotor is same for three-phase squirrel cage induction motor. Okay. The power input to a 415 volt 50 hertz 6-pole three-phase induction motor running at 975 rpm is 40 kilowatt. The stator losses are 1 kilowatt. The friction and windage losses are 2 kilowatt. What will be the efficiency of the motor? Okay. So they have mentioned that it is a 415 volt, 50 hertz, 6 pole, 3 phase motor. Okay. It is running at 975 rpm and the power is 40 kilowatt. Okay. The stator losses are 1 kilowatt. Windage losses are 2 kilowatt. So we have to find out the efficiency of the motor. So when the three phase source, we are giving 40 kilowatt input power. Okay. And we are losing 1 kilowatt as a stator copper loss and core loss. Okay, so this output is 39 kilowatt. Okay, and we can see here, we can calculate the slip as, okay, 1000 minus 975 divided by 1000, so 0.025. So stator output is, we get 39 kilowatt. Okay, gross mechanical output is rotor input into 1 minus slip. So we are getting 39 kilowatt into 1 minus 0.025, so 38.025. okay. So this is a net power. Okay. From the net power, we are losing friction and windage losses. So 38.025 minus 2 kilowatt. Okay. So 36.025. Okay. So efficiency is output by input. Okay. We are giving input as 40 kilowatt and we are getting output as 36.025. Okay. So efficiency is 36.025 divided by 40 into 100. Okay. So we are getting an efficiency of 90%. So choice B is the right answer. Okay. Again, I'm repeating. The power input to a 415 volt 50 hertz 6 pole 3 phase induction motor running at 975 rpm is 40 kilowatt. The stator losses are 1 kilowatt. The friction and windage losses are total 2 kilowatt. The efficiency will be, okay. So we can calculate the slip as 1000 minus 975 by 1000 equal to 0.025. Okay, stator output is 40 kilowatt and 1 kilowatt is the stator copper loss and core loss. So we are getting 39 kilowatt. Okay, the gross mechanical output is rotor input into 1 minus slip. So rotor input is 39 kilowatt into 39,000 into 1 minus 0.025. So 38,025. So net mechanical output is 38,025 minus friction and windage losses. So windage losses they have given 2 kilowatt. So 38,025. Minus 2000 is 36025. Efficiency equal to output by input. Okay, so total output what we are getting is 36025 watts, and then 40 kilowatt is the input power we are given. Okay, into 100, so 90%. A three phase wound rotor induction motor is to be operated with a slip energy recovery in the constant torque mode when it delivers a power output of P naught at slip S, then theoretically the maximum power that is available for recovery at the rotor terminal. Okay, so we have to calculate the maximum. So power input to the rotor is PGM. Okay, so the gross mechanical power is P0 equal to 1 minus slip into PGM. Okay, so slip power required equal to slip into PGM. So PGM is a power input. Okay, so S into P0 P output divided by 1 minus slip. So choice D is the right answer. Okay, a three phase wound rotor induction motor is to be operated with a slip energy, okay, at the constant torque mode when it delivers the power output of P naught at a slip S, then theoretically the maximum power that is available for the recovery at the rotor terminal is equal to P0 into slip by 1 minus slip. Okay, a 400 volt 50 kilowatt 15 kilowatt 4 pole 50 hertz star connected induction motor has a full load slip of 4%. The output torque of the machine will be, okay, so we know the formula, power output equal to 2 pi nt by 60. Okay, so we are here, we can calculate the speed n. Okay, so we can calculate the ns equal to 120 f by p, 120 into 50 hertz by 4. Okay, so 1500 rpm. So speed will be 1440 because slip is 4%. So torque equal to 60 into power divided by 2 pi n. So 60 into 15 kilowatts, so 15 into 10 power 3 divided by 2 pi 1440, so 99.47 newton meter. Okay, generally if 15 power is mentioned in the motor, it is the power available at the shaft of the motor. Okay, if I mention the 15 kilowatt, it means that 15 kilowatt is the power available at the shaft of the motor. Okay, so input power of the motor will be vary depending upon the efficiency of the motor. Input power may be 16 kilowatt, 17 kilowatt or 18 kilowatt, whatever it may be, because it depends upon the efficiency of the motor. The motor efficiency will be sometimes it will be in the range of 70 to 90 kilowatt. Okay, it depends upon the type of motor. Okay, so again, I am repeating, a 400 volt 15 kilowatt 4 pole 50 hertz star connected induction motor has a full load slip of 4%. The output torque will be, okay, we know the formula, power output equal to 2 into pi into nt by 60. Okay, pi is substituting that, we can get the value of torque. Okay, here the thing to be remembered is power equal to 15 kilowatt, 15 into 10 power 3. Okay, determine the correctness or otherwise of the following assertion and the reason. Okay, so under V by F control method induction motor, the maximum value of developed torque remains constant over a wide range of speed in the subsynchronous region. Okay, the reason is the magnetic flux is maintained almost constant at the rated value by keeping the V by F ratio constant over the considerable speed range. Okay, here the assertion is also right and the reason also right. So both A and R are true. R is the correct reason for A. Okay, so choice A is the right. Under V by F control of induction motor, the maximum value of developed torque remains constant over the wide range of speed of the subsynchronous region. The magnetic flux is maintained almost constant at the rated value by keeping the ratio V by F constant over the considerable speed range. Okay. The speed of four-pole induction motor is controlled by varying the supply frequency while maintaining the ratio of the supply frequency V by F constant. At rated frequency of 50 Hz and rated voltage of 400 volt, its speed is 1440 rpm. Find the speed of 30 Hz. Okay, here they are using the V by F method. Okay, so for 50 Hz frequency, for 400 volt, the speed is 1440 rpm. Okay, we have to find out the speed for 30 Hz. Okay, so for this, in generally, if V by F method has been used for the same torque, the drop in speed remains constant. Okay, so here we have to find out the synchronous speed for first frequency and synchronous speed for second frequency. So NS1 equal to 120 into F by V, F 120 F, okay, 120 into 50 by 4 equal to 1500. Okay, here NS2 equal to 120 into 30 by 4, 900 rpm. Okay, so the difference in speed is NS1 minus N1 equal to NS2 minus N2. So 1500 minus 1440 equal to 900 minus N2. N2 is 840. Choice C. Okay. In a V by F control method, this for the same torque, drop in speed remains same at different frequency. That is a hint. Okay. Just try this question. Give the answer in the comment box. A three-phase cage induction motor is started by using a D-coil switching at the rated voltage. If the starting current drawn is 6 times of full load current, okay, and a full slip of 4%, the ratio of starting torque developed to the full load torque. We have to find out the ratio of starting torque to the full load torque. Okay, and we have to see the value. Okay, and answer for this question I will provide in the next set. Okay, if you like this video, means press the like button. Okay, and all the best for your examination. Okay, I will upload some other videos soon. Thank you.